Okay, people, I'm back, but I've got some disappointing news. Okay. Let's just say that between the last part and this part, right, I was shooting part two, and I got, I would say, about 40 minutes in, okay? 40 minutes of footage of recording the Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit and the assembly and everything. And I had the battery light came on the camera. I quickly said cheerio to everyone, and then basically the batteries decided to run out. Now, because what happened, I had to change the batteries, and upon putting the new batteries in and setting the time up, I then went to the contents of the memory card, and I found that basically, because the batteries run out before the footage could be saved to the memory card, it effectively corrupted the memory card. Okay, so I have lost 40 minutes of video footage on how to put together the Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit. Okay, so unfortunately, we're just going to have to resume from this point, and I'm just going to basically try and fill you in on what I've done so far, and go at it from there, really. So yeah, I've lost 40 minutes of footage, and but fortunately, right, and there's always a good bit of news, people, right, I've not lost anything too important. Okay, all it was about me waffling on about how to secure it to the bits and pieces to the board, how to wire it up, do this, do that, and do the other. I can just basically repeat myself a second time over and basically recover what I've lost that way. So if I now pick the camera up, there we go. Everything is now secured to the board. Okay, I'll just take that off of there. As you can see, everything is now secured to the board. In what was the original part two, I was putting the screws in, securing it on. I wired that up, secured that to the board. I'm really, really disappointed because I showed you how to wire that up inside there, how to strip back this cable. If you remember in the other video, I had this sort of cable, and those were accommodated in it. What I was saying in the other video is how to strip this stuff back. Let's basically get a knife and run it right the way down the length in the middle, like that, right to the end. And then, as you can see, that's what I've done. I've run it right down the middle to the end. And when stripping this stuff back, what you do is when you put the knife in, you lean the blade towards the earth conductor. Where is the old earth conductor? There it is. I pulled that out. There's the bare earth conductor. When you're running the blade down that, you lean it towards the earth conductor, and that acts as a guide, because you don't want to hit the other cables because they've got insulation on them. Okay? And then you just pull that like that and like that, right the way down the length, and you get your cores out, like so. Okay? And then wire them up. But unfortunately, I've lost that footage where I stripped that back and took all the cores out. I've measured these to length, snipped them off. That's what those offcuts and excess bits were about. Interestingly, the offcut is long enough we could actually make another Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit out of that. But I'm going to use that in a minute to show you what I'm going to do. Now, I was preparing a little earth bridging strap at the point that the batteries came on the camera. And what that's for is, if you can see those earth terminals there and there, I'm just basically going to put that in there and that in there, and then that joins those two boxes up for earthing, okay? So I'm going to get on and do that now. We're 5 minutes in already. I'll just set the camera down there a minute, people. Okay, I'm going to push that through there. Okay, in there like that, and it'll come out of there like so. There we go. Oh, look, it wants to go to that earth terminal. There you go. It's found its own way. So there we go. Let's put that in now. I'll just turn that around like that. Let's undo that earth terminal. Okay. Right. That's going in there just wonderful. Let's tighten it down. Like so. Right, you can see what I've done there. Okay, that's in there like that. And then that goes through, and I'm going to put that onto there like that. Okay, so you just bear with me a moment, people. I'll just put that other one in. But yes, I am really, really turbo disappointed with losing that footage on that... of that, you know, the 40 minutes of footage on that memory card. Really, really super disappointed. It's just, yeah, an absolute loss that was, because I had everything on that memory card. And there you go. Right, it turns out, people, here's another disappointment. That that wire going into that earth terminal, right? It's just, it is that much too short. Okay, so I'm going to have to pull that out, reject that. It's just that little bit, wee bit too short. Okay, so I'm going to take it out carefully. I'm going to measure a new part because I've got all this excess. So it's not too much of a problem. Okay, so there we go. Again, when snipping your cables to the correct length, it is worth noting, and it's pretty obvious. You can shorten the cable, but you can't make the cable longer. So what I'm going to do is offer up that new piece and snip that where my finger is. Again, the excess, you can tuck that away inside the box. So I'm going to snip it there. Okay, so there we go. A pair of wire cutters. Okay, there we go. And I'm going to strip the ends back, sharp knife. Okay, but yes, it's going to take me a little while just to get over the disappointment of losing stuff on that memory card, you know. You see, I always thought, right, that the footage was being saved on the card as you recorded, okay, but it's obviously not. It basically records everything, and then when you press stop, it saves it to the memory card, okay. And of course, if it's not saved to the memory card and the batteries run out mid-flow, it results in the memory cards becoming corrupted, because you've only got half a file on there. And the camera and the computer that you put the memory card into does not know how to run half a file. So what happens is, basically, it doesn't run. And of course, when I put the memory card in the computer, it was showing up on the computer screen that basically the card was half full. Okay, it said the it's a 2 gigabyte memory card I've got, and it was saying 1 gig free, 1 gigabyte free, and 1 gigabyte used. But when I opened the folder up, there was nothing in the folder. Okay, all I had in there was the little icon for the video format, and then it just said 0 on it, 0 bytes. So basically, it was a an empty vial. It didn't save it. So yeah, hugely disappointed with that. Really disappointed. So, right, I've now got that earthing strap in place. Okay, let's pick the camera up. There we go. Going in there, through there, into that one. Okay, I've left that loose, right, and I'm going to show you why I've left that loose in a minute. Okay, and that is to do with this. Okay, because this earthing wire has got to visit this socket first. And it's got to come out of there, through there, into the other socket, there, and then from that socket to that, and then that joins the whole lot up. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to say, take that, okay, about there, that's to the edge of the box, and then add a little section on, and that is going to be the point at which I cut that, and then strip the end back and put it in that earth terminal. There's the earth terminal right in the middle there. Okay, so let's get on with that. I would say about there, because I can always push that excess back in the box. Okay, see where I've got my thumbnail? That can go back in that box ever so easily. Okay, and you always want that bit of excess which so you can pull the socket out away from the confined to the box, so that if you ever need to get in there at a future date, you can do, and you've got plenty of excess so that you can get to the workings inside the box. So let's take our pliers, okay, pair of pliers, wire snips, shorten that down. There we go, that's that shortened, and that little piece of earth wire, I'm going to keep that because that has got to go between the socket. So I'm going to keep hold of that, put that there. We're going to strip this back now. Okay, I'll just set the camera down there, people. I know it's not much for you to look at, but I cannot hold the camera, the cable, and the knife at the same time, which is a very sharp knife. Okay, so I'm stripping this back now. But so yeah, I'm hugely disappointed with that memory card. That was a right letdown. That's 40 minutes of footage, people, and I lost it. I lost that footage. It's the first time it's ever happened on my camera. You know, normally speaking, when I get the battery light come on, I'll just quickly say cheerio and press the stop button. Everything saves to the memory card, okay, and then I switch the camera off. And that's it. You know, everything saves nicely, no trouble at all. Right, I've stripped that back now. And then what I'm going to do is do the same to that. So we've got two cores, and then those are going to go into that terminal there. Okay, see it says E on there. There you go, E. That's the earth terminal. L for live and N for neutral. Okay. Right, so let's strip this little piece back now. I'll just set you down there. Let's get on and do this now. Okay, right, just strapping that back. Again, you know, the loss of that footage, that 40 minutes of footage, it's just something I'm going to basically just have to bite the bullet, accept that it happened, and just press on, people. Okay, that's 40 minutes. Me talking about how to put together a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit. And, yeah. The batteries run out, the whole lot was lost. Very, very disappointed with that. So, there's our little piece there now. I'm going to then prepare our socket by undoing that terminal screw. like so. I'm going to put my, hold it down with my foot, get that screwdriver in there, and undo that terminal. There we go. Now these terminals, and you can accommodate two of these, or possibly three. Okay, you can get three of those. It's 2.5 millimeter size, that, and get three of those in there easy. But we're only going to be putting two in because that's all that's going to be on this wiring configuration. So I'm just going to put that in now. Okay, that's one. Okay, in goes the other one, and then tighten that screw down. Again, it's really important to make sure that your terminals are done up very tight. Again, I was saying that on the other, I'm going on about that lost footage again, and I was saying about that on the other video, not the one that you've just watched, but the one that I lost, about making sure the terminals are done up tight in that. So there we go, that's coming in, going in there, and then it's coming out of there. And then on the other end of that, we're going to have this socket. Okay, so I'm going to pass that through there, out that end, like so. Okay. Yeah, so like that. Okay, just let me prepare that, people. Right. So there we go, that's coming out of there now. There you go. And then, when that goes, that there goes into that terminal, and then you're going to have to make up another piece to come out of there and go to that terminal. Okay, it's all fun and games, it's all wonderful. So there we go, let's strip this back now. Again, you know, this is doing a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit the proper, safe way. Okay, that other thing that I use, that was just something that I quickly knocked up for a bit of fun, just so that I can get a couple of videos out of it. And then I'm going to do this one so that you can see, firstly, how to make a safe Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit, and secondly, how one is wired up. Okay. Right, you know, you remember earlier on I had that bridger wire which was too short. I am going to use that between there and there. So, although that was too short, it's not without a use. So, I'm going to save that. I'm going to reuse it. Okay. So, I'm just going to re-prepare those strands on the end of there, because as I tore that out in disappointment, I did damage the strands ever so slightly. Right, I'm going to put that into that terminal now on the box. Okay, and going in. Okay, right, let's tighten it down. Again, after you've tightened your terminal screws, just give those wires a little pull, just to make sure they are gripped in the terminals. Right, let's pick the camera up. And I've got those two now. Okay, so you can see I've put them in there like that. And then those two go in there. Okay, so let's do that now. So just put that together. Okay, that one goes in, and then that one goes in. Like so. And then we just tighten that screw nice and firmly and securely, of course. Right, the earthing of the system is now complete. Let's pick the camera up. Okay, right, here's what happens. The earth, which is there, okay, got my finger on it, comes in, visits a socket, comes out through there, visits a socket, comes down there, goes to the box to make sure the box is earthed, comes out of the box, back through, and into there. And then it just ends at that point. Okay, so it's a nice little loop going all the way around. So, now that we've got that wired up, ordinarily speaking, at this point, you'd get both of these and put them into that socket. But hold on a minute, people. This is a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit, okay? Things on a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit run a bit differently, not as they should be. Okay, what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to take the red wire, which is live wire, and I'm going to put it into that socket. And then the neutral wire, I'm going to put it into that socket. Okay? And then, take this off cut, and make a bridger between the two, so it joins them up. And then what we've effectively got, alright, is the power comes into this socket, goes through a load, back in, across to this socket, comes out, through a load, back in, down the neutral wire, and back to there. That is how a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit is wired up. So I'm now going to put that in there. I think that off-cut actually would be long enough to make a bridger wire out of. So I'm now going to shorten that, strip it back, double the end over, and put it into the live terminal on that socket, okay? So, I would say about there is a suitable length. Okay? So I'm going to cut that now. Again, before I cut, it's always worth noting that if it's too long, you can shorten it. If it's too short, that's it. You've got to start again. So I'm going to go about there. Okay, so here we go. There we go, that's gone shooting off over there. Let's just go and recover that piece, because I will need that. And that can serve as a bridger between the two sockets. So, let's strip that back now. Double that conductor over and stuff it in that socket. Okay. There's just something on the underside of that scraping the floor. Okay, I'm just going to check on the other side, underside of that minute, people. Hold on. Nah, it's okay. All is okay. Right, I'm going to strip that red wire back now. Okay. Again, I cannot remember if I said it on the lost footage, but I am using a cable which is of the old British colours. Okay? If you're using some new modern stuff, then basically the red that I've got will now be brown. Okay? And the black that I've got will now be blue. So there we go. It's just a little bit of information for you. I cannot remember if I said that on the lost footage or the video that you've just been watching. Okay. But I do know one thing. I lost 40 minutes of footage. Right, I've now prepared that conductor there. You can see that I've doubled it over. That is so that when the screw goes onto that inside there, it's got plenty of conductor to bite into. okay, because that earth terminal's got two conductors to bite into. So is that one, and so is that one down there. That one doesn't matter, okay, because it can take just one. So I've just doubled that over to make sure there's plenty of conductor for that to bite into. Now that technique, I've done the same inside this. Again, that was part of the lost footage, people. Okay, I did actually do that on camera, but I lost the footage. So let's put that into this socket now. Okay. Now, because even though it's a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit, I am going to wire it up into the respective terminal. Okay, so I'll just get the socket now. Can you see? Where is it? There's that N there, N for neutral, and where is it? The L there for live. Now, the live is the red wire, okay, which is that. Or if you're using the new EU colours, that'll be blue, okay? I've messed that up, haven't I? This and the new EU colours would be brown, okay? This would be blue, this one. So I'm now going to put that into that terminal there. Okay, I'll just set the camera down a minute, people. Again, it's really difficult to hold the socket, hold the screwdriver, the wire and the camera. It's all a bit difficult. Okay. Yep. It's all a bit difficult. So, I'm just going to offer that into there now. Just tighten it down. Again, as soon as I start turning that screw, starts biting into that conductor. That's what we want. Now then, pick the camera up. You can see that I've terminated that off in there. And as you can see, that insulation goes right up to that terminal, okay? You don't want to see any conductor sticking out. Okay? So, what I'm now going to do, right, is I'm going to take this neutral wire and run it through the joining section. Just hold on there a minute, people. Okay, it's going through. Okay, it's through. Right, there we go. There you go, it's coming in, it's going straight through, out the side, and there we go. And that will go into the neutral terminal of this socket. Okay, so that will be, so I'm trying to get it in the light for you people, it's a bit difficult, but it's that terminal there, basically, cutting straight to the chase, that one. Okay, so I'm going to shorten this now because it's way too long, strip it back, double it over and stuff it in there. I should keep talking to you as I'm doing the works. Again, measure the length of the cable you want. Always remember, if it's too long, you can shorten it. If it's too short, you've got to start again. As we found out, remember that bridger wire that I'd done between there and the earth wire? It was too short, I had to start again. So, if I mess this one up, I've then got to have all this off, redo the whole lot, and I don't want to mess that up. So I'm going to go to about there where my thumbnail is, get the wire cutters, and there we go. Okay, that's nice and short now. And then I'm going to strip it back, double the end over, and then terminate it off into that socket. Okay, now do remember people that I am wiring these sockets up in a way that they wouldn't normally be in the average household, okay? What we're doing here is a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit. Okay. Things inside this run a little bit differently. Okay. So I'm doubling that conductor over now. Again, this takes a bit of practice doing this. If you get it just right, like you've seen me do it in the other socket, it looks nice, it looks wonderful, and you get that nice satisfying feel when you tighten that screw down. As soon as you start turning that screw, it bites into that conductor and you can feel it really wanting to hug that conductor and make a nice solid electrical connection. So I've now doubled that over. Okay. And we're going to put it into that terminal there. Let's do that now. In she goes, and tighten that terminal right up. 1, 2, 3, and it's starting to bite. Oh yes, it's biting that conductor nicely. And there we go. Right, so there it is. So we've got the live wire going into this one and the neutral wire going into this one. What we now want to do is take a piece of wire, put one end in there and the other end in there. Okay, so I'm going to now just estimate whether that's going to be long enough, and I don't think it is. So instead of wasting time trying to prepare that, I've got this bit which is really, really long, and I'm going to use that and then shorten that down accordingly. And we'll go in from there, people. So let's start stripping this end, this piece of cable back now. Okay, let's double that over. Give it a nice bit of grit. Okay, once again, got a doubled over conductor there. Okay. So we're going to put that into there. Let's set the camera down again. In it goes, like so. Putting that screw down, and straight away it starts biting into that conductor. That's wonderful. Right, so that's the wiring on that socket now complete. Okay, now this wire, and to push it all the way through there, okay, if it will go, which it is going to, it's got to. Oh, a minute, people, just let me set the camera down a minute. Okay. Right, all the way through. Come on, you know you want to, you've got to. This is my Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit, and you must behave, you wires. Right. So that is now through to the other side. Okay. So it's coming in there, going back in there, and coming out of there. And then I'm going to shorten that, strip it back, and stuff it in that terminal. Okay, so once again, I would say about there for length. Okay, about there for length. Wire snips, and 3, 2, 1, there we go. Let's now set about stripping that back, doubling it over, and stuffing it into that terminal. Yeah, so this would have been, and I'm sure it's going to be anyway. I'm sure you're going to like it and give thumbs up and all that lot, people. But as the video was before I lost that footage, this was going to be one epic little video. You know, it would have been about an hour long. Okay, the first part we had was, what, 20 minutes? I can't remember now. And then we would have had a 40-minute one. 40, maybe a 50-minute video. Yeah, it would have been three parts. This is supposed to be part three now, but it's actually part two. Because part two got corrupted in the file system. And, yeah, it would have been about an hour and 20 all in. Three parts, an hour and 20 minutes. Okay. So I'm just tightening in that wire now. I've stripped it back. I've doubled it over. In the terminal block it goes. And the wiring is now complete. So let's just run through what happens. There's an earth connection. Comes in, visits a socket. Comes in, visits a socket. Goes to the box, back through to the box. The neutral, well, let's go with the live. The live comes in, visits a socket, and then comes out through a load, back in there, all the way down, out there, out, through a load, comes back into the neutral, all the way down, all the way through, straight through there, and back. That is the wiring of the wiring and the wiring configuration of how you put together a fun jiggery pokery unit. Okay, so now we've got to dress those cables into that box, sit the sockets back on nicely, and then secure them down. Okay. So, I'm just going to do that now. I can't do it on camera, people, because I'm going to have to hold the board down. Dress those cables neatly into there, and then carefully sit the sockets onto the boxes. Okay, so let me just set the camera down now. We're 37 minutes in once again. So, I think, really, out of all honesty, if I hadn't have lost that footage, we would probably be looking at approximately, I would say, all in, about 40 is about 120, maybe, two and a half hours worth. Right, so I'm tightening the socket up now. Okay, that's one socket done. There we go. And I've dressed all them cables neatly in there. What I've done is I've put them in and just sort of coil them round in the bottom of the box. Okay, let me just do that one now. Okay, in they go. That's looking wonderful. Okay, right. Give it a bit of pressing. And then what I'm going to do is we'll just give it a quick test to make sure that you know, we've got basically the power's conducting through okay and whatnot, and yeah, we'll go in from there. Right, the fun jiggery pokery unit, people, is complete. There we go. That is it. One lovely little solid unit. Okay. Again, this is nice and solid. You can take knocks, you can take bumps, you can kick it around. Yeah? You get the idea. It's nice and solid. Take knocks and bumps. So, yeah. It's all good. Nice, solid little chunky unit that can take knocks and bumps, be pulled and kicked about, and okay, You get the idea. It's nice and solid and chunky. Unlike that other thing I had, if I dropped that, it would have just smashed everywhere. Okay, if I'd just given that other one that sort of treatment that this has just been subjected to, it would have broken everywhere. And that is why we've got to have a nice, safe Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit. Okay, now, I've got this. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use this as to test it. Okay, so I'm going to put that in there. And I turn that on. I'm going to turn that one on also, just for the hell of it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to test on there for the earth. Okay. And then going to touch on the boxes and whatnot to see if I've got earth continuity. And in there. And then I'm going to go for the live. See if I've got live in there. And then the neutral in that one. See if I've got neutral in there and there. And then once everything is... I'm happy with everything. We'll then plug in. I've got a couple of subjects that we can try it out with. And we'll go out from there, people. Right, I've got the tester. It's just a funny little continuity tester, okay? It's nothing special or expensive. Okay, so... Right, there's my little tester. Okay, it's a wonderful little thing. I've had that since I was about 8 or 9, because that's when I started doing electrical. And I got that as a Christmas present one year. Let's just test if we got continuity. Okay, it's one of these things where you, when you touch it, the little needle goes up. There you go. I'm just touching that together on there. Okay, it's always worth testing the tester. And then, I'm just going to touch inside... There, let's put one probe in the earth, like that, okay, so pick the camera up, there you go, that's one probe in the earth, and then touch that on the earth conductor there. Yep, we've got on earthing on there, earthing on the first socket and the second socket, all looking good, people. Then we're going to do the neutral. Okay, right, that's the neutral socket there, in that one. Right, that's the neutral socket, and this is the live socket. Oh, we're dealt with our changed pins in there. Yeah, all is good, people. So, who wants to see... Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit being fired up for the first time. You know you want to, people. You know you want to. Right. Here's how. Let's pick up the camera. We take this. We then plug it straight on there. Let's turn that socket off. There we go. Plug it straight on there. Yeah. Again, it's a bit difficult to do this and hold the camera because it's got one of those spring flaps on there. Right, like that. That's what I was trying to do. And then that goes on there like that. Okay. Again, I've got three things to hold on to here. Right. That goes on there like that. There we go. And then that snaps closed on there. Okay. Right. Just to bear with me a minute, people. Okay, but who remembers this? The vacuum cleaner. Okay, this, in my very first video, the one which is called Fun Electrical Jiggery Pokery, it's in that video that you'll see that vacuum cleaner. So we're going to put the vacuum cleaner in that one, like that, turn it on. And then, if you just bear with me a minute, people, I'll go get my fan heater. Okay, I've got the fan heater, and here it is. Remember the fan heater, people? Okay, fan heater. Okay, right. Let's get the plug. Like so, and oh dear, we've got a problem, people. Look at this. Look, that will not go in there. So I've got a converter. Okay, converter. That goes to the fan heater, like so. Right, let's put the fan heater over there, like that. And then that goes in there, like so. Okay, that's on. And then that's on. So what we've got to do now is just get that to a wall socket, okay? I'll just get an extension cord, to people. Hold on. Okay, I've got an extension cord. Right, I'm going to have to show you the whole setup, aren't I? Right. Let's pick the camera up, people. Okay. Right. Here's the whole setup. That is going through the converter to the fan heater, and this side is going to the vacuum cleaner. I'm now going to plug that from our Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit into there, like so. That's all now live. Okay, so that's the fan heater, and that is the vacuum cleaner. And of course, when I do this, okay, that starts up, and then when I turn onto 1 kilowatt, the vacuum cleaner starts up. There we go, people. And of course, safety. Turn the switches off. But never rely on the switches, people. That is why that's there. Just get hold of that. And if I just pull on that, physical brake. Okay. So, we've now got a physical brake between the main supply and our Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit. That is why that is on there. So you can get that physical brake, okay? Never rely on the switches, because although they look like they're on, that can fail, okay? So I've got that on there with that, so we can get the physical brake. So there it is, people. That is how to make your own Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit, okay? Now, I'm probably going to get a few comments from people saying that they don't know where to get all the bits and pieces. So, what I'm going to do basically, if you are really, really interested in making a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit, but you want all the bits and pieces, what I may consider doing, if I get enough interest, right, and bearing in mind, this is for people in the UK only, okay, I will basically get a kit of parts, okay? You can pay me through PayPal, because I've got a PayPal account, and then I'll send all the parts to you, and you can have a go at making your own, okay? So there we go. That is how to make a Fun-Jiggery-Pokery unit. 49 minutes in so far, people. I don't know how long it's going to take to load this on the old YouTube. But, yeah, there we go. So there it is. Thanks for watching, people.